मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, यस आई होप एवरीबडी यू हैव रेड द लास्ट टू लेसन्स, इज़न्ट इट चिल्ड्रन? विजयनगर किंगडम एज वेल एज बहुमनी किंगडम, इज़न्ट इट? एंड मोस्ट यू हैव कंप्लीटेड योर नोट्स आल्सो. फ्यू मेंबर्स आई हैव चेक्ड व्हाट यू हैव सेंट इन होमवर्क, दैट आई हैव चेक्ड. ओके, वेरी गुड. एंड कंप्लीटेड मैप आल्सो यू हैव कंप्लीटेड. ओके, वेरी गुड. So today we are going to learn one more lesson, children, that is called civics part, or our Indian politics, that is our constitution. What is that? Our constitution. What is that? Our constitution. Samvidhana. What is the importance of this constitution? Why we need constitution? Do you know that? Yes. I think everybody, what we are following in our state or India or in our country, what we are respecting, what we are following, the rules and regulations. Yes, who made this? So little question in your mind, isn't it? And one more thing, during the time of 1947, because British people, they were ruled here, isn't it, children? Yes. So, in here, we don't have the rules and regulations independently in India. During that time, what the British people, because they were ruled here, right? So that what they made the rules, that we were following, okay? After that means during the time of independence, here Mahatma Gandhi ji, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, Jawaharlal Nehru, Motilal Nehru, Chittaranjan Das, and Bhagat Singh, and so many, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, everybody, all those who are the freedom fighters, everyone, they were trying to bring the independent country, isn't it, children? So during that time, because of the independence, they were having the satyagraha movements. They were conducted against the British people to integrating India or Karnataka. There were lots of battle was taken, or lots of incident was happened, like Jallianwala Bagh massacre was happened in Punjab, isn't it, near Amritsar? So because of the freedom, our freedom fighters, they were dedicated, they were sacrificed their life. So now we have to remember that, isn't it, children? That is our major duties. We have to respect them. And for the freedom, we got the freedom 1947, 15th August, right? Because of our freedom fighters' achievement. Then it was declared, means whatever they have written, Sardar Vallabhai Patel and Jawaharlal Nehru and Ambedkar, they were written something, and it was declared in 1930 January 26th. What is that? January 26th. What they have written, January 26th, 1930, it was declared as a Purna Swarajya. While they are conducting the movements only, they were held the National Congress session in the Lahore. So during that time, January 26, 1930, they were declared India as a Purna Swaraj. Okay, children? So on that day, now January 26th, we are all celebrating Republic Day. On that day only, India, they were declared Republic State. Okay, children? So here, we are having, or we are following some rules and regulation, isn't it? Before that, there will be a election held at 1951 to 52, because 1947 we got the independent, but we don't have the rules and regulation in our country, or there is no leader, particular leader was not there. So because of this, all the constituent assembly means under the presidentships of Rajendra Prasad, What is that? Rajendra Prasad. He was a first president, isn't it? He was a first president of Constituent Assembly. And all other members means there was a 299 members. So they were formed a Congress session. And so 299 members also they were participated in this session. Then they were created or constructed one constitution. That constitution, it was accepted January 26th, 1950. Then 1951 and 52, they were held the election. In this election, they were given the chance to voting for our adult members. Means those who are 18 years above, that people, they were given the votes for the leaders. Means representatives, those who are the representatives. Here, the first election was held in the 1951 to 52. During this time, Jawaharlal Nehru became, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru became a prime minister, first prime minister of India, and Rajendra Prasad was the first president of India. After that, who was written this constitution, do you know? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Yes? So, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, he was elected as a, or he was appointed as a law minister from 1947 to 1950. After the 1950, once the constitution was accepted, during that time, he was appointed as a chairman of drafting committee. What is that? Drafting committee chairman. Who was that? Yes, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Okay, children. So, now we are having the doubt why we need this constitution. Is it necessary for us? Yes, children, it is necessary. Yes. Why? Because it was taken almost 11 months to complete. 11 months, 18 days. It was taken to complete the constitution. Okay, children. Means it was written by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He was written the constitution. In this constitution, administrations, rules and regulations for the country or the people, means citizen of India, what we are having the rights and duties, means fundamental rights, six fundamental rights are there, that the fundamental rights and duties of the people or the citizen of India. So it was written in the constitution. Then what are the rules we have to follow as a citizen of India? That is also in the constitution. Not only for that, our parliament, it is having a three organs, isn't it, children? Yes, our government, union government, what we call that? Union government or the central government. It is having three organs. One is legislature, executives and the judiciary, isn't it? So, all three organs also, it is following the constitution, what they tell us. Okay, children? Then, we need a constitution because we need a respect to our country, isn't it? What is the meaning of constitution? Why we have to follow? Yes, children, it is very, very important. Constitution means it is a set of basic rules. Basic rules for whom? For us only. Basic rules means, what is that? Moolabhoota hakku, isn't it? Means basic rules and regulation, rights of the citizens. This is called constitution. It is a set of basic rules. It is in the written form. Means they have written. It is a written document for our country. And one more thing it is, India, it is a independent country. Now it is not. After 1947, it was not ruling under any other country, other foreign country. We are ruling. Here people is making the rules. Here people is elected the representatives or their leaders. Okay. Do you know that Abraham Lincoln, he was an American 14th president. He was a president of America during the, when it is? during the 1930 time. Okay, children? And he said about the democracy. Means, what is the meaning of democracy according to Abraham Lincoln? By the people, of the people, for the people. What is the meaning of that? By the people means people only we are making these. And of the people, people only started this. And for the people, it is only for the people. Whatever it is, by the people, of the people, for the people. That is called democracy. Okay, children? Means we people only, we are electing the representative. Then they will make the rules and regulation for people only. So what they are ruling, that is also for the people only. Okay, children? So it is called democracy. So India also wanted to make a democratic country. For that reason, Ambedkar, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, he was written the documents, written documents. In that documents, what it is there? About the rules and regulation, administrations of our government, and fundamental duties and the rights of the people. Here, in this constitution or whatever the law, they made this, everybody should adhere it. Everybody adhere means from the beggar or like we people and include president, prime minister, judiciary, executives, all the executives means all the ministers of the parliament. So everybody should hear both their head. Why means? They have to adhere, they have to follow the rules, they have to respect it, what the constitution says. So like that, our constitution was formed. So this constitution was accepted during the 1950 January 26th. Before that, 1930 January 26th, our freedom fighters, they were declared as a Purna Swaraj, isn't it? So because of that day only, they have accepted the constitution and made the India as a republic state. On that day, on which day, children? Yes, 1950, January 26th, it was accepted by the government. Okay, children? So now, we will learn about what is the types or what else are there in the constitution. First of all, children, in this constitution, there will be a 2473 amendments was there. What is that amendments? Tiddupadi means what? They have written the laws or rules for the country. How much it is? 2473 amendments was there. Then 395 articles are there. What is that? 395 articles, 2473 amendments and 395 articles. In that articles again they made a 22 parts. In that 22 parts, now present 8 schedules are there, children. How much it is? 8 schedules. So these much rules and regulation and the laws they have written in the constitution. For that reason, it is the lengthiest, right? So, Indian constitution, it was the lengthiest, children. And no one constitution of our other countries, they are having like this lengthiest constitution. India, we are having like this. So, that it is, it has taken to complete 11 months and 18 days. Okay? So, what is its importance? I already said, everybody should adhere it. Isn't it? So, who are the people of this country? Each and every citizen, include Prime Minister and the President or all other ministers, any political background people, they must adhere to our constitution. They should bow their head or they should respect the constitution. And secondly, constitution, it will protect our rights. It will protect our citizens' rights. Okay, children? And how it will protect means all are equal. It will tell us all the rights and the fundamental rights and the duties what the constitution has given. It will gives all the people equally. It may be socially or it may be politically. Okay, children, or it may be economically. So it will be equality or it will be equal. And it will functions as a reference guide to the government. Means government also they have to make some rules and regulations, isn't it? So on that time, constitution laws what will tells that it will functions means government is following the constitution laws. Okay, and it will be coordinating in between the constitution and the government and the people or citizens. What is that? It will functions as a reference guide to the government one side, and it will coordinate the functions and it will maintain the relationship between the people and the government also. So this is the importance of the constitution. And one more thing, it will be creating the better relationship between the people and the government. Between the people means those who are the individual people, means we people. Okay, so between us and the government, it will create the better relationships. So this is the important of the constitution. What are that? Everyone should adhere it and everyone should follow the rules and regulation of our constitution, and it will protect our rights and duties, and it will functions the as a reference guide of the government, and it will be coordinating the functions of the government organs, the three organs, that is legislature, executives and the judiciary. Okay, children. Then it will create the better relationship between the people and the government. So that it is very, very important to follow the constitution or constitution rules and regulation. And this constitution, what it will tell us, do you know that? Yes. First of all, daily in the morning past prayer, we are all making the pledge, isn't it, children? What is that pledge? We the people of India having solemnly resolved. Yes or no? That preamble, every day in the prayer you are all telling, isn't it? Have you remembered? Okay. One second, you remember that? What is that? We the people of India means all the people, we are all one, isn't it? So, we the people of India means this preamble called, it is the heart of the constitution, children. Preamble, it is means that constitution book, first page, they were printed this preamble. It is about only us. We are all one. We are all equal. Socially, economically and religion, whatever. Whatever the constitution will give us freedom. So we are all here equal. That is what preamble will says that. What is that? We are the people. We are the people of Indians, isn't it? Then what it will say? Sovereign, secular and socialist, isn't it? And what is that? It is a democratic republic, isn't it? What is the meaning of sovereign, children? Yes. What is the meaning of sovereign here? Means any other country, they are not ruling us, or the other country's law we are not following. We are having our own country law, rules and regulation. Now, after 1947, we are all ruling for ourselves only, isn't it? Because we people only elected the representative, isn't it? So that is called sovereign. So that India, it is a sovereign state. It is not dependent to any other foreign country. It is only for India. It is independent. That is what sovereign. And socialist. Socialist means those who are the different types of the religion, different types of the caste people are there, or it may be poor or it may be rich people are there. Everybody, these constitution laws or the fundamental rights and duties are equal. That is what socialist. Then secular. Indian constitution has given the freedom to following any types of the religion, children. So that India is accepting all the types of the religion, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Sikhs, Parsi, whatever. So those who are the religions, different religions, they can worship their own temple or the God. It is not interfering, but we are having the freedom to follow the religion. That is called secular. It is a secular state. Idanna kannadadalli enantare andre jatyatita rashtra. What is that? Secular state means? Means we are not discriminating in between the any caste or the creed. Okay. So that is called secular state. And another thing is democratic rights. Means there was a, not there was a, now still also we can see in Saudi Arabia. For example, Saudi Arabia. Yes, there is a monarchical rule. Means king rule. How we are all having before the 1930, how we are we were having the kingdom rules like Delhi Sultans, Mughals, Vijayanagara, Wadayas, Tipu Sultan. So many kingdoms they were ruled here, isn't it? There was a rules made by the king. What the king said that we have to follow during that time, isn't it? So, but now what the constitution, what our country rulers or the president or the prime minister, they'll say that the rules we are all following, isn't it? So that is called democratic republic. Why? Because we people only conducted the election and we people only selecting the people, those who are having the power, means powerful leaders we are all selecting, isn't it? And that elected representative, he will make the government, he will form the government, they will make the rules and regulation for our country, isn't it? So that it is called democratic and republic. Democratic means people's government it is. Republic means 1950 January 26th only. Once again it is united and it has declared, it was declared as a republic state, isn't it? Means on that day, we have accepted the constitution. So, it is called sovereign state, socialist and secular and democratic and republic. Okay, children? Now, you are all having the small doubt, isn't it? What it is in the constitution? What it will say? What are the features, unique features for our country? Yes? Have you doubt? Yes, I'll clear it, children. First of all, we can say that it is a written document. What is that? It is a written document. What is the meaning of written document, children? Do you know about the written document? Before that, yes, I'll go through this. Written document, it is the lengthiest document. Yes or no? Only India is having a lengthiest, largest document. That is also in written form. What it has written? About the administration, country's administration and citizens, citizenship, rules and regulation and fundamental rights and duties of the people and what the Indian citizen should do or Indian Indian, as an Indian, what we should follow the rules and regulation for our country. Everything they have written. Apart from that, we are the three organs, isn't it? In our central government we are having, not only central, it is for the state government also. We are having the three organs, legislature. Legislature, it is making the laws for our country. And the executives, what the laws will say, that is executive, means prime minister or those who are the MPs and the MLAs and those who are the ministers, everybody, they are called executives. Governor, president, prime minister, these are all people called, what is that? Yes, executive. So these executives also, they should follow the laws. Then judiciary. Judiciary, already we are having the independent judiciary. So that judiciary, what is that? Law, executives, legislature means law. Legislature and executive and judiciary, these three also, they are following the constitution laws. Okay, whatever the articles are there, schedules are there, parts are there, amendments was there, everything they were following, these three organs. Because of three organs, now we are all having the peaceful life. We are leading the peaceful life here. Okay, children, so that it is called lengthiest written document. Our constitution first features is, what is that? It is a written constitution. And secondly, I already said, what is that? It is a republic. Yes, what is the meaning of republic? Here, we people are not having any king or not king rules, isn't it? Or any communist rules. We people are electing the people representatives and they will make us, they will rule us, isn't it? They will make us rules and regulation and they will rule, isn't it? So here, 5 years once election will be held. Those who are the candidate will have the vote, highest or the majority votes, they will get the ministerships. Okay. So all the minister, we are having the bicameral legislature system, children. What is that? Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha. At the central level also and the Karnataka state level also, we are having the bicameral legislature. One is Rajya Sabha and one is Lok Sabha. Okay. So in Karnataka, what we have? Yes. In that Rajya Sabha, again, what we have in Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad, right? Male Mane, Kela Mane, like that we are calling. Okay. That we will discuss in the another lesson, children. Okay. Third one is fundamental rights. What is the meaning of fundamental rights and duties? What it is? It is also one of the feature of the constitution. Fundamental rights of the citizen means what? What else are there? First of all, first fundamental rights. One is, these fundamental rights who has given? Government, our government has given, isn't it? Our central government has given the fundamental rights, means authority for the people, children. So one is right to equality. What is that? One is right to equality and right to freedom. Right to equality means we are all one. Everybody should have the equal. It may be politically, it may be socially, or it may be economically. Everyone should have the equal rights to participate in the government program or government or administration, whatever. Okay. And secondly, right to freedom. We are having our own freedom. We are having the freedom of what we can, freedom of speech. We can, means we can speak without any hesitation. That is called freedom. Okay. So freedom of speech. And we can follow any religion here. And we can follow any caste. And we will move apart from the country. Means inside the country or any other country also, we can move freely. Okay. But we have to follow some rules and regulations of the country. Then, right to against exploitation. What we have against the exploitation. What is the meaning of against exploitation? Means there is a child labor, isn't it, children? Or child marriage. So these are all, we should avoid that. We should control it, isn't it? So this any However, always they were troubling the lower classes people, isn't it? Like what you call that labor or jitadalu, land, bonded labor. So, like that they were treating. Before the 1947, they were treating like that. But our Ambedkar has written in these fundamental right, one of that, right against the exploitation. Exploitation means what? Do you know that exploitation? Iga yaradru obru nimmanna tuliyodu athwa nimma mele dabbalike madodana en karitare exploitation. Okay, so next one is the right to religion. Here we are all accepting the Christianity and Islam religion, Hindu religion, Bauddhas, Parsi, Sikhs, Jainas, so on. Lots of religions are there. So we can worship our own religion, or we can worship any our own God. We can go to the temple or any religious ceremonies. So there is no restriction. That is what government has given, right to religion. Next, cultural and the educational right. We are having our own rights to learn the education, children. Or we can participate in any cultural activities. And next one is right to constitutional remedies. Means what the constitution is having the remedies and what it is protecting us, everything we have to adhere it, children. Means we have to bow our head. Okay, so this is called fundamental rights. These six fundamental rights you are going to study about the next lesson, children. Until then, another thing is fundamental duties. Not only rights we are having, instead of the rights we are following some duties also. As an Indian citizen, we have to follow the duties also. For example, we have to protect our cultural heritages, monuments, and we have to follow the respect the national anthem, national flag. Yes or not? We have to show our respect to national anthem and the national emblem as well as national flag. Then, while singing national anthem, we have to show our respect to standing, isn't it? Standing in attention position. Then, basic education rights they have given. For example, basic education means from 6 to 14 age, we must have the basic education or the elementary education. That rights we are all having. And we need to protect our environment and surrounding, isn't it? We have to protect our society, family, and our country, isn't it? So these are all the rights and the duties we need to follow. That is what constitution will say is fundamental rights and the duties, children. Next one is, it is a secularism. I already said, what is the meaning of secularism? What is that? What is that secularism means? 1976, there was a 42nd amendment. Andre tiddupadi madlaitu 42nd article. So that is telling about our national religion. Means we can follow our religion. We are accepting all other type of the religion also. But there is no discrimination among any castes. Here it is called Jatyatita Rashtra. It is called secular state. Okay. We are not discriminating in between the any other caste or the creed. Okay, children. So here each and every caste people, they are all equally in socially, economically, as well as political rights. Okay. That is called secularism. Next one is, it is an independent judiciary. Yes. Constitution is having an independent judiciary where we are having, yes, Supreme Court. What is that? We are having the Supreme Court at Delhi, isn't it? So, Supreme Court, what it will make, what it will gives the final judgment that everybody should follow. Everybody should adhere it. That is what we are having, only one judiciary, that is also independent judiciary. So in this judiciary, legislature or the executives or any other political background people, they nobody should interfere in this judiciary. Then in this judiciary, Supreme Court will take the final decision. We are having the subordinate courts in our local and the High Court is in our state level. But Supreme Court, it is the final judgment giving court. Okay, means every equality they will see, every documents they are observing, after that they are giving the decision. What it will give that decision or the judgment, so here each of the Indians they should follow, include Prime Minister, President and all the ministers also. Then universal adult franchisee, one more feature it is universal adult franchisee. What is the meaning of universal adult franchisee? Means in India, those who are having the 18 years and above, that age, it is called adults. That adults, they can vote, they can elect their representative. So for that government or the election commission, it is giving us one identity card, that is election identity card, children. So as a Indian citizen, those who are the adult people, they must complete their 18 or 18 years above age. Then he has having the rights to vote the people, okay, and he can elect the people. That is called adult franchisee. Means to bringing the equality of the socially, economically and the politically, they made this adult franchisee. Okay, next, last one is election system. I already said that adult, those who are the adult people, they will give the vote. Those who are the candidates, that candidates, whether he will rule correctly or not, or if he was having any criminal background, then we cannot select it, isn't it? So that type of the right person, those of, like Modi. Now Modi, everybody, they are appreciating the Modi, because Modi, he has done the achievements for us, isn't it? Our whatever the duties and the what we are all following, everything, these government or the Modi like people, we are all electing, isn't it, children? So these are all called elections system. This election system we are having from the 1950 and the 51 time, first election was held. So this is about the constitution unique features, children. So today what we have to do, you have to read the lesson first, go through the lesson and preamble, what you are understanding, everything you have to read again and again. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in a WhatsApp, children. Thank you.